Hey everybody, this video will give you some nice impressions about Planet Sirene. It was done in the first 2 days of the launch of Planet Sirene, which means it was a soft launch. They already claimed that not everything is ready at this date. To be honest, I'm not pretty sure about this planet and about its future. And unfortunately my English is not good enough to give you the correct sentences, but I hope you get the point what I try to say. Currently the mobs are very bad balanced, a lot of items are not discovered yet. The economy is totally down because you cannot mine any resources and stuff like this. So okay, this will be fixed in the next few weeks, I assume, so this is not my big issue I have with the planet. They did a really amazing job on the models and especially on the animations of most of the enemies. So in this video I will show you some of them, and you will see that they have very great fighting animations, amazing dying animations on some robots. So, yeah, really a lot of good design here. The planet is pretty well designed from the landscape aspect too. So, the trees are very, very great designed. The landscape is very cool. Unfortunately, I have to say, most of the areas look pretty similar. So you have more or less three different themes on the planet, and to be honest, this is not enough for a totally new world. It looks way much too close as the other planets in Entropia. I am afraid that it's too complicated for a planet partner to make a huge redesign on many areas on the landscape. So I think we will see no big changes in the next year here, which means most of the landscape is well designed, but it still looks not much different from the other planets. You will see very nice designed trees, or small areas are very nice designed, as the huge waterfalls and stuff. But I have to say, I'm very disappointed about some parts of the planet. Especially the areas I will show you now are the Greeks, look pretty much like a Greek area. And it's way too big. It is, you know already, it will be empty all the time. It's a very, very boring area. So especially an arena like this, of course it will always be empty. You cannot put many players into it because yeah, the servers can't handle enough players to fill the area. And if we make it an area with mobs in the center, then still, I mean, that's a huge area and it's totally empty. So this whole city is a total crap design in my opinion. The architecture is great, the buildings are very detailed, but from a game perspective, it's just a boring place. And we have seen stuff like this a lot on Entropia, on Calypso, years ago, and I really don't understand why a designer creates a city like this. Maybe something very cool is missing here. Maybe they have a great idea to fill this place. But currently it looks like nice designed, totally dead area. Another thing which is good on one side and bad on another side is that yeah, the sound on the planet, yeah, it's very well designed. It feels much more like a living world. Some areas, especially around teleporters, often have annoying sounds, but I think this can be fixed easily. So yeah, as I said at the very beginning, some aspects on this planet are amazing, very amazing design, very great animations. Some of the weapons are pretty cool, stuff like this. So, yeah, it looks like it has a lot of potential. On the other hand, at least currently, it looks like it's just another world which we already have seen. So nothing that is totally different. And I hope we will see a huge difference on all the maps, on all the mobs that will come in the next weeks. The planet already has a lot of missions that are not standard grinding missions. On the other hand, I didn't find any grinding missions until now. I am totally aware this planet is not finished yet, but on the other hand, I have to say, we have seen other planets starting, so I was expecting to see this planet start with more content. As I said, currently, good points, bad points. I would rate it 3 out of 5 points, or 3 out of 5 stars. So it has potential, and we just have to see what happens in the next 2 to 3 months, which I think is a time that is needed to fix a lot of things and add more content. And then I think we can make a real comparison to Planet Acadia, which I like still the most, and compared to Calypso, which is, yeah, a pretty static planet. So just let's see what the future brings.